Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for the World Television Championship, set for one fall, with TV time remaining. Introducing first the challenger from Hollywood, California, 234 pounds, Ryan Ryan!
Well, it'll be Lord Steven Regal going up against Antonio Inoki on August 24th during the Clash of Champions, and what a classic confrontation that should be between those two great mag technicians.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, accompanied to the ring by Sir William from the Tower of Blackpool. He weighs 18 stones, 2 pounds, and is the World Television Champion, Lord Steven Regal.
There is rather a disdainful look on his face most of the time.
I'd like to punch him right in the mouth again. Him and Jerkington.
Lord Regal, World Television Champion, being taken on now by Flying Brian. Should be an exceptionally fast moving match from the standpoint of Flying Brian.
Well, that would be Brian's best option. Keep it moving. You know, a contrast in styles here for Regal wrestling Flying Brian as opposed to Antonio Inoki. You know, I guess you could say Inoki is to Japan what I am to the world of living legend.
Well, I'm certainly
in agreement.
Of course. There you see the TV championship belt being displayed by Nick Patrick, our referee. Don't forget, tonight, of course, our main event will be pretty wonderful, going up against the Stars and Stripes. And on Sunday nights, of course, it is the main event with Mean Gene Okerlund and Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Look at Pillman already attacking the psychological part of this human chess game, trying to get Regal a little flustered. But I got news for Pillman. Regal can control his emotions to a point. He's very, very good in that ring.
No question about that. They loosen up now. They meet collar and elbow. And let's see which man is going to gain the advantage. It is Lord Regal with a bottom wrist lock, then into a full arm drag and twist.
See, we could have a mistake by Pillman already off the bat that will set the precedent for this whole encounter with Lord Regal. He locked up with Regal and he's trying to wrestle him. I don't think so. Here's what Pillman wants to do. Just keep moving, moving, moving.
Well, that shoulder smash was very effective. Regal back to the canvas, back on his feet again.
See, Pillman's going to have to play his game in there. To wrestle Lord Regal is going to be a mistake. Because Regal, like, yeah, he's a great mat technician. You cannot, you know, disrespect that fact, or you're asking for it.
Well, Antonio Inoki, obviously very upset. Figures he lost face against Lord Steven Regal, so that'll be settled on the 24th during the Clash of Champions.
You know, Japanese, very weird culture. I mean, they're big on their face. Of course, Inoki's face isn't really something to be proud of, but in the eyes of his people, I mean, this guy's a senator in Japan. I mean, it's a disgrace because the Japanese media have jumped all over this.
Well, it's not a weird culture, Larry. It's a different culture from ours, but a very honorable one indeed. Nice spinning head scissors that time by Flying Brian, down with a side headlock. Now look at Lord Regal trying to break it up, trying to get a head scissors back, but could not do it.
Yeah, he had to get the back of his knee underneath the chin of Pillman. That way he could have took it right back, but he couldn't get that leverage. Pillman, he'll hanging on here.
By the way, he broke his knee down that time. Beautiful move by Lord Regal. Took his man down to his knees, but he's still caught in that side headlock.
Yeah, well, Flying Brian hanging on to the basics, and you can see Regal trying little of this, little of that. I think the more Pillman wrestles him, probably the bigger the mistake. Pillman's got to keep moving. Not to mention he's given up a lot of size and weight here to Regal.
That he is, and he's caught with a couple of forearms under the jaw. Another forearm, and now a full-arm drag and twist by Lord Steven Regal. Had a little extra leverage that time. Nice bridge by Flying Brian. And beautiful counter that time by Flying Brian. Has Lord Steven Regal possibly in trouble here? Catches him another hip lock takedown down to the canvas. And the referee started to count.
Well, I tell you what, he's doing the right game plan here. He's keeping it basic. Snatch that headlock on. Try to keep Regal, you know, off his feet in that prone position. And so far, so good, but I don't trust Regal or Jerkington.
Well, a lot of people feel the same way. Regal got one cheap shot into the midsection, and there's another one into the midsection of Flying Brian, and then took his man straight down to the canvas.
Yeah, so here's the thing with Regal. I mean, he's got the pressure going. As soon as Flying Brian tries to, you know, move his weight, Regal just slides out of it, and now Flying Brian's in trouble. You know, again, that height and weight factor. You got Jerkington outside. Almost, you know, what is Hulk Hogan thinking about Ric Flair with Sherry Martel outside? We all know how vicious she can be.
Yep, and we're going to find out a lot about it on the 24th, just a little over a week away. 11 days.
Oh,
caught him coming in. Reverse body slam, and that may be all she wrote. No, sir, he powered out. I'm amazed he was able to.
Yeah, well, that just, let's applaud the conditioning and the tenacity of Pillman, because the normal mortal man would have been ended by now. Regal hit him with a beautiful move there. That's what I'm saying. He's just a tough competitor in that ring. Pillman has just got to keep moving. And he's not.
That seems to... Ah, there's that wicked forearm again by... And again by Regal. Then a forearm to the side of the head. He's adept with either arm in that regard.
Yeah, let me tell you, first-hand experience, that's nasty, because what he does is he swings that arm up, hits you in the chest, but when your body gets sweaty, as soon as it hits the chest, it goes right up in your jaw.
Beautiful drop toe hold and a float up by Lord Steven Regal. Gets that side headlock on Flying Brian Pillman, keeps him down on the canvas, and brother, he is issuing some punishment now.
Yeah, look how he's got his hands locked right there, cranking up the pressure on the head and neck of Pillman. Has all his weight over the man, and he's still working on that neck. I tell you, this guy could make you suffer.
Yeah, that's his only position in the ring. He doesn't like pinfalls. He likes submission holds when he defeats a man. And notice the way Pillman's head is cocked to one side as he's caught in that headlock. Pillman finally fired to the midsection, then one to the chest, another one to the side of the jaw. He's got Regal staggered, but only momentarily as Regal fires back.
And the chess game goes on. Oh, ho, ho. Right in the royal chopper.
Dropped into the canvas. Of course, on the 24th, we're talking about Dusty Rhodes and Dustin Rhodes, his son, facing Bunkhouse Buck and Terry Funk. You got the Nasties against Pretty Wonderful. That one's hard to call in advance.
Well, it's going
to
be a great night of wrestling, and of course, the price is right.
Yeah. Right here on TBS. Wednesday, August 24th. Cedar Rapids, Iowa.
Look at Regal here again, just interlocking the arm, got the pressure on the neck. Hey, rubbing the face of Flying Brian while he's putting the pressure on the neck. Talk about, you know, making someone suffer in there.
He had hooked Flying Brian's arm, so they had him working against himself. And again, he tries for that pinfall, unable to get it. However, Flying Brian keeps popping up out of there. Now he catches another forearm. Flying Brian fires back, and now Lord Steven Regal giving it everything he's got. Irish whip reversed. Lord Regal swings around, catches his...
Oh, it backfired on him.
Sure did. Lord Steven Regal smashed into that turnbuckle.
Hey, here's where the endurance and the training pays off. Pillman, he's got a second win, but he's got to keep it moving.
High backdrop by Flying Brian. Regal comes up slowly, catches a boot to the midsection.
dropped.
Totally off guard that time as Flying Brian comes hurtling off the top rope. Catches him. Beautiful drop kick.
Hit him! Hit him!
Catches Sir William outside. And Flying Brian in behind his man gets the sleeper, I believe.
Oh, he got the jawbreaker.
Man. That's the thing about Regal.
Hey, Jerky,
Sir William, yeah.
Goof.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match and still World Television Champion, Regal.
Hold me back, Gordon.
Well, just have to be cool, Larry. Keep your career separated here. Hi, August 24th, Hogan and Flair in a great rematch upcoming. Here on TBS, the Clash of Champions.
Hey, for a few yen, I might have to have a little talk with Inoki.
Let's take another look. You see him getting behind his man, getting that sleeper hold, and this could be the beginning of the end, but look at this, Larry.
Yeah, hit him with a jawbreaker. You know, Lord Regal, he's got to move a minute, Gordon.
He does indeed. And I'll tell you what, we'll be back in just a moment.